I know something's out here.
Same thing.
Someone's out here.
What'd you find?
What's up? I'm in here.
All right, kid, hang on. I'm coming.
Mr. St. John? Oh, thank God. Thank God.
It's just Deke, kid.
They were gonna cut me up. They were gonna eat me.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, you got this? Can you get your gas, then get your ass back up to camp? You got it?
Yes, sir.
God damn
yes,
it,
sir.
Don't call me sir, it's Deacon.
Yes, sir. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Should be it. Hey, Ricky. I got him. He's on his way back.
Deke, what happened?
Well, he ran into some drifters who were... Oh, Jesus. Let's just say that he was on tonight's menu.
Oh, my God. Cannibals?
Well, I honestly didn't stop to ask them. Deacon out.
See if I remembered how to make anything. Stop by when you can. I think you'll like it.
Oh, booze man. Yes, yes. I always need more shit. Thanks, brother. Deacon out.
St. John, heard you ran into some cannibals today.
Hey, Mike.
Hey, Mike. Yeah, they were about to cut up Jeremy Gibbons.
God almighty, what drives a man to give up everything that makes him different from a goddamn animal?
Well, you know what they say. There's only 9 meals between us and all hell breaking loose. And I'd say we're well past those 9 meals.
Yeah, maybe so. Hey, thanks for saving the kid, Dick. I'll make sure we put him to work. Maybe hold off that hellfire for another day or two.
Done. Yeah, sure, Mike. Whatever you say. St. John out.
One of the camps can use this. Hi. I guess it's kind of pointless to, say anything, since I know that you, didn't die out here. Just a habit, I guess. But, coming out here every so often, talking to you. That was the only thing that kept me sane, you know? So, thank you. Yeah, okay.
Hey, did the kid make it back okay?
Hey, Dee. Yeah, he's a little shaken, but he'll live.
Good, good.
Iron Mike said he even volunteered for marsh duty, if you can believe it.
Oh, I believe it. Hey, let me ask you something. Does he call you ma'am?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. See you, Ricky.
At the gate. Hey, it's Deacon.
Hey, Deek. How you been?
There, you are looking fine today.
Here you go. Now that's an upgrade. Yep. Good choice. Okay. All right. Deke, take care now.
Hey, how's it going, Deke?
Hey, Joe.
Got good shit in stock today.
Buzz.
I'll fill her up. I got you covered. See you later, Deke.
All right, let's see what the old man's got to say.
You know a way over the Teelson Pass. You told me once that
I told you nothing. Go on. I can't help you, Deke.
Just draw me a goddamn map.
After everything you've done.
After everything I've... What about what you've done, old man? Huh? Sherman's camp, the things that you
get out of here. You leave me.
Listen to me. What if you could take it all back, huh? What if you could fix it? The night that I put Sarah on a chopper, I felt relieved. How fucked up is that? I was relieved, Mike. That's what I've been living with.
And now you're chasing ghosts. You think finding your old lady, if she's alive, you think that's gonna fix it? Make you whole?
I don't know, but I gotta try.
All right. If I do this, what you want, show you the way over the pass, you don't come back. All right? You promised me you don't come back.
I gotcha. Shit. Now I gotta talk to Boozer.
Hey, Deke. How you been?
Blair, how's it going?
All right. Don't be such a stranger.
Sorry.
Look up.
Yeah, see you, Deke.
Holy shit.
Boozer, I...
Last winter, we were up on Farewell Ridge. We were watching the freaks. Thousands of them. I mean, too many to count.
Yeah, I remember.
All I could think was, every one of us, man, woman, and child, are now homeless. Bunch of goddamn refugees. Yeah. World belongs to them now.
We'll survive.
Yeah, we've been doing that all right. Surviving isn't living. Something Jack used to say. Doesn't matter when you hit the road, where you're heading out to, but you damn well better know where you're coming home to.
You know, we never talked about it while we still wore the colors. All this time out in the freak show and shit like this didn't matter anymore.
Yeah, but I think. Last two Mongols on Earth, Farewell Originals.
The biker boys, most badass drifters on the broken road.
Damn straight.
Yeah, I guess we did become sort of a brand.
Yeah. We were a lot of things, but we were never a brand.
When we rode out of Farewell, without Sarah, without Jack, or anyone, I knew that we were leaving everything behind. Everything that mattered was gone. Except this.
nomad again, huh?
Yep, I guess I am.
Come on, Jack. Inside, let's go.
She's out there. You find her.
Deke, you ready?
Yeah, Mike, I'm ready.
Meet me at the gate. Don't keep me waiting.
Yeah, sure, Mike. Whatever you say.
Hey.
Heard Big Mike is taking you over the pass?
Yep.
You really think she's still alive? Billions of people are dead, but somehow she made it.
Hey, we made it, didn't we? If I give up now, if I don't do this, well, then I'm just gonna end up
like us, right? Like Iron Mike, like Boozer? What'd you call us, campers? Yeah?
You go, and you find your woman. You know where to find me.
And you know what? You know what I think, Deacon? I think that you're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
You ready?
Yeah, I want to get the hell out of here.
Okay, I'm following you.
Jack out fishing once. Before, you know.
Oh, shit.
I got one. Didn't know what the hell to do with it.
That sounds like Jack.
Now you're in a pretty tight club. Where you boys raised some hell back in the day. I don't think you murdered anyone. Not in cold blood.
It's not murder if they shoot at you first.
You know how many tourists we used to get through here come summer?
A few.
Thousands. Too many to count. Highway'd be bumper to bumper with SUVs and campers chock full of sunburned moms, beer-chugging dads, and their snot-nosed kids. Goddamn rainbow, floppy hats, Hawaiian shirts, and flippy-flops. All summer long they come. A trail of colorful ants from L.A. to Farewell to here, nonstop.
I'm glad I avoided road trips out here that time of year.
This is as far as I go. Keep following the trail. It'll take you down the mountain, on into the Diamond-like Valley. I wish you luck. Hope you're right about your old lady still being alive.
She is.
Well, maybe so. But you gotta ask yourself, Deke, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
Never know what tomorrow may bring. One life next to you could be a memory. I've idolized, I've memorized your face, just in case the need lasts me eternity. It's a shame. That ain't enough for me. Life's for the little, I won't be giving up. 'Cause you taught me how to, you taught me how to love. Take all I cherish, beat me till my body's numb. Life's for the living, I won't be giving up on you. But Last for the living, I won't be giving up on you. On you. Even though I know you would tell me to.
If you're out there, I'll find you.
What the hell?
Won't open.
Come on, you can do it!
me, man!
Oh. You.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know what we would have done without you, man.
Oh, come on.
Hey, okay, all right, all right, all right. It's dead. It's cool.
Man of the hour.
Oh, God.
I'm Russell. Glenn Russell. This is Private Mullins.
Rick.
Hey, Rick. I'm Deacon St. John. Did you say private?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Deschutes County Militia.
You're not from around here. You come over the pass?
No. I've just been drifting. I came over the salt flats east of Silver Lake.
What the hell are you doing out here, man? How'd you get across the 97?
Whoa. Jesus, man.
What?
This guy just saved your freaking life.
The colonel told us to look out for anybody entering the territory, north or south.
Freaking slow your roll, man. We'll let the captain deal with that, okay?
Fine.
He just killed a freaking ranger, dude. Come with us. We got a camp just by Diamond Lake. Get you 3 hots and a cot. Least we can do.
Okay, yeah, sounds good.
What about Flores? We can't just leave him here.
You stay here. I'll come back with some fuel.
No!
Listen, stay here. Use his ammo if you got it. You'll be fine. Okay?
Following you.
You gotta stick with me, okay? I've been having some trouble with squatters out here the past few weeks. If patrol picks you up, could be trouble.
Okay, got it. So, Deschutes County Militia?
Look, man, all I know is they feed me. They want me to salute them. Yes, sir, I salute and say yes, sir.
How big's your outfit?
The camp out here? We got 100, maybe more. Hard to keep track. Back at HQ, a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, okay. Any women?
Hell, that what you're about? Well, you can forget it. Colonel's got rules about that. Fraternizing! Yeah, that. Look, you pull your weight, follow orders, nobody messes with you. Women same as the men. Don't matter to the colonel.
I'm not... I'm just... Looking for some people and a woman that I rode with a year back or so. They would have come over from Silver Lake, and they would have been at one of those Nero refugee camps, I think.
Silver Lake? Jesus, man. Silver Lake's been gone a lot longer than that.
Yeah. It's too goddamn easy to lose track of time out of here, you know? Anyway, you guys, do you pick anyone up? Survivors, I mean, from the refugee camp?
Maybe. Like I said, it's a big freaking army, you know? Ask the captain. He came in across the salt flats, I think. He might know.
Captain?
He commands the Diamond Lake outpost. We're almost there. This is it.
It's Corporal Russell. Open up.
Report.
Captain, sir, we had him. We did. Found his bike still smoking.
I bet you lost him, huh?
No, sir. I mean, yeah, we lost him. We ran into a rager, sir.
Where's Mullins? Flores?
Flores is dead, sir. I'll have Mullins with a body.
That'll be all, Corporal. Go get some fuel. Head back to Mullins. You know what to do.
Yeah. Yes, sir. If it wasn't for this man, we'd all be dead, sir. I sort of promised him some food and a safe place to camp tonight, sir.
Corporal, get the fuck out of here. And you are?
Name's Deacon St. John.
Name's Corey. Derek Corey. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I've been on the road for a long time. Your man Russell said you were recruiting.
What, you interested?
I've been looking to settle down, yeah, find a camp. I'm interested.
Come on.
So, together. How long have you been drifting?
Keep it together.
Hard to say. Lose track of time out there, you know?
So, where'd you get your gear? Ammo?
Well, there's a couple of camps I used to do runs for. Bounty hunting, mostly.
Freaks? Or men?
Both. I had a reputation for being able to track shit down, you know?
Oh, which camps? Where are they?
You know, past the Farewell Valley. It doesn't matter. They're gone now. They're overrun. Russell said you were there when Silver Lake was overrun.
Yeah. That was a shit show, I can tell you.
Any survivors?
A few.
Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle?
Here. Take this. Militia script. Camp credits. Payment for helping my men. Use them at any of the commissaries.
Okay.
You gonna join up? Stick around. We're getting ready to ride out of here soon.
Getting ready to ride out where?
You said you had some tracking skills.
Yeah, some.
This isn't the life of a drifter. We're fighting a war out here. You sure you're up for it?
Is that the best you got?
I can recruit you. But the colonel is the only one who can swear you in. You stick around. Give us a hand. I'll take you to him myself.
I'll be here.
Good.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus, motherfucker has my ring. He took it from Sarah. He had to take it from Sarah because she wouldn't have given it to him. So that means that she's gotta be here. He doesn't look like militia.
Go, go, go! You've got to move your ass!
I haven't seen you around before. Lucas Monroe.
Yeah, I just shipped in, you know. Deacon St. John.
Well, take a look around. I got all kinds of bike parts, if you got credits.
Yeah, thanks.
A good piece of equipment right there. Oh, okay then.
Hey. You don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man. Name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy shit. Deacon St. John. Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
See this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Whew. So what? You joining up? Becoming an army man? You playing soldier and shit?
I don't know. Maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man. Yesterday. Okay. Yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people, we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up. He wouldn't remember Sarah if she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah, come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. Somewhere. Maybe in these tents. Maybe in here. Nope, not here. Check this one. The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right? Ah, damn it. She's not here either.
You're not looking so good.
It's gotta be the one. Sarah? Sarah, you in here? Shit, not here. God damn it, she's not here. She's not here, but... Right, yeah, it couldn't be that easy. Now, could it?
St. John, you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah, I'm here.
Meet me at the gate.
On my way.
Why are
you not working? Rumi, right? Hey, I gotta ask. You seem a long way from home out here.
I was studying theater at the community college here. Go fighting platypus. Yes? I was an exchange student from Yokohama in Japan.
I kind of figured that.
Yes. Anyway, as you say, a long way from home. Oh. Whoa, goodbye.
Whoa, whoa. See you later.
Come on! You can run faster than that.
New around here? Name's Ava Bergstrom. Friends call me Bergie.
Deacon St. John. Yeah, I just got here.
Well, Deacon St. John, you do your job, and we'll get along just fine. How's that?
One, two.
Yes, ma'am.
Moving, Sergeant.
Yes, Sergeant. Yes, Sergeant. Let's
see you
work,
later.
People.
Hey there.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready when you are.
So you put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, some.
Looks like a forest fire, but the stumps are charred. That means that the timber was cut before it was burned.
You got a good eye. We call it the dead zone. We use the timber to build our barricades, then burn the slash. From the outpost, we can see a horde coming long before it reaches us.
And what? You're gonna burn all the buildings too, so the newts and the swarmers have nowhere to sleep?
You know you're free think so.
Like I said, I've been out in the ship for a long time. So that's your plan, huh? Militia, I mean, to burn everything to the ground?
We're fighting a war out here, St. John. We'll do whatever it takes to win.
A war?
That's what it is, isn't it? War? You've been out in the ship. You've seen the hordes. The only thing that's gonna stop them is an army. Our army.
It's gonna take way more than an army.
We have a plan. The Colonel lets you join, we'll fill you in. So, Silver Lake, you asked about survivors. You looking for someone?
No. No, not really. I mean, look, there were some folks that I rode with once, and I thought maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after someone. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. I tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
Corporal, the captain's here.
It's done, sir.
Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab, Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
Oh, yes, sir.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
You find something?
How long is,
Vasquez.
What has Vasquez been with you guys?
A couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason. I can't track him from the bike.
Where do we start?
It's been snowing, so, there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
I can use this. Yeah. I can use this. You said he stole rations? Ammo?
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it. His bike's still out front, which means that he went out the back. Wait, over here.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently.
Yeah, come on, this way.
Hey, hold on for a second. Look, over here.
Tracks?
Yeah, we're in luck. This way.
Wait, hold up.
You find something?
Yeah, shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here. Hold up.
Go on, get out of here.
What are you doing? That ever work for you? Yelling at a wolf?
Depends.
On what?
On how hungry it is.
Yeah, not bad. Look out! More wolves!
I see him!
That's the last of them.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks like it. Nice work.
Yeah, worth some credits.
I want to take a look at this thing. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot, right through the head.
Yeah, the wolves must have heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
You think they chased off Vasquez, leaving one to guard the carcass?
That's my guess.
Come on, let's see if you're right.
You guys got a lot of wolves out here? Ones that aren't infected, I mean?
Yeah, we get reports almost every day.
When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies.
Well, it looks like they're making a big comeback.
Hold up.
What is it?
It's a backpack.
It's one of ours.
Looks like they almost got to him.
And he shrugged off the pack to get away.
Nah. To buy time. He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots.
You can tell all that.
Yeah. Right there with you. I gotta say, I'm getting tired of running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah, I've done it before. You just gotta keep moving.
Look, if you're gonna join the militia, you must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight freaks.
Being in the shit, killing freaks, it kinda goes hand in hand, doesn't it? Okay, put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell a corpse from about a mile out.
Part of our slash and burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything else.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them, just in this part of the state alone.
Yeah, we gotta start somewhere. All right, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead,
or he's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Okay, come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The colonel will fill you in, if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't want you to get your hopes up.
Hey, don't worry about me. I don't really give a damn either. Hey, wait. Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Wow, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. If Vasquez is there, what would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead.
Why?
Well, it means Vasquez isn't coming without a fight.
You see your man?
Yeah. That's him.
Well, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Oh, come on, boss.
Oh, see about that.
Oh, hell no.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order? You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
Got him.
Give me cover if you have to.
saw something.
Take that. I guess not.